Robert, how did the Big G respond that the fight's now official? Because he didn't like the fight initially.
He didn't like the fight, and I called him last night.
Did he know?
No, he didn't know.
Okay.
I told my dad, it's official, and it's all over. He's like, all right, well, that's good. You know, we didn't want it, but it's all right. And then I told him, yeah, but fuck, the size is fucking big difference. He's fucking big, dad. He's like, look, Robert, we were against this fight, but Mikey always wanted it. For some reason, he wanted it. So now that we got it, fuck the size. I'm gonna go out there and train Mikey to beat fucking Errol Spence. My dad says, fuck the size. Yeah, he's big. So what? Fuck the size. My dad says, that doesn't mean anything. That doesn't mean we can't beat him. So now we gotta train Mikey to beat him.
Have you studied Errol Spence?
Yes. He's been watching. We were against it. But now that it's on,
it's reality.
We gotta train him to beat him. That's it. And it's possible.
Robert, is this the toughest fight you ever were involved with, like coming in as an underdog?
Probably one of the most. Well, look, I've been on you know, the biggest, yes, you know, but I've been on a lot of my fighters have been underdogs.
Of course, but you always pull them off.
You know, Brian Viloria was underdog big time when he fought Archie Solis and knocked him out. Stevie Luevano, we went to Nicky Cook's hometown, knocked him out over there. Maidana was the underdog against Broner.
And Mayweather,
and you know, fucking beat the shit out of Broner and beat Mayweather, but Mayweather got the decision the first time. Then
Brandon Rios Peterson.
So it's not like we've never
Abner Mars has two squares.
It's not like we've never pulled it off. But yeah, this is like the biggest, most risky fight. Yeah, I would say so.
A fan is asking, are you upset about the fight?
No, I'm not. Fuck no, I'm excited about the fight.
This is his excited face.
I'm excited about that fight.
They say you look mad.
No, I'm not.
They don't know. I mean,
I'm not mad. Why would I be mad?
Robert, it's a big fight. These are prize fighters.
Is it a big risky fight? Yes. Wow. Is it a dangerous fight? Yes.
But it's great for boxing, Robert.
Are we gonna be the underdogs? Yes. But fuck, everything's possible.
The best is fighting the
best. Leonard did it. Fucking Broner did it against Malinagi. Yeah. Let's say maybe Malinagi's not the Errol Spence. But neither is Broner. Broner's not the Mikey either.
So here's my question.
And Broner did it, right? Broner did it. He moved up to welterweight to beat Malignaggi. Yes, Malignaggi's not Errol Spence. But Broner's not Mikey either.
Spence is southpaw. He's big. Who do you bring in for sparring? Do you know yet?
Well, look, I know I already have one in my gym that's gonna be here for perfect timing, you know, because he just fought and he went back to Brazil for the holidays, obviously, but he's coming back in January, so it'll be perfect timing for him to spar Mikey. That's Esquiva Falcao, and I already
talked. Olympian medalist.
Yeah, silver medalist, and he's a middleweight, and I also talked to Hector, my friend Hector from Santana. He's gonna bring in Alexis Rocha, so that's another one. And we might bring one more, cause you know we normally have three different sparring partners. I know Falcao and Rocha are also gonna be getting ready for fights, but we have two rings, so we could always use other guys. You know, like Falcao is gonna spar Mike a few rounds, then he could go to the other ring and spar Misael Rodriguez, you know what I mean? So we're gonna have plenty of sparring. You know, those guys are, you know, can get in the bed with Rocha and with Falcao, and then we're gonna bring one more. So, you know, I'll look up, you know, somebody that's gonna be good and help us good sparring.